whenever I come across information that's new to me and could have serious implications, I do my best to share that with you all, and today's video is one of those times. I've shared many audio clips of Dr. Greger discussing the incredible benefits of spermidine and spermidine-rich foods, which he features in his new book, How Not to Age. But in a recent Q&A on nutritionfacts.org, Dr. Greger mentioned that there are some people who may need to avoid or greatly limit spermidine-rich foods, especially like Wheatgerm and Tempeh. This is because the research points to there being a theoretical concern that spermidine could play a double-edged sword role for some people. So let's hear from Dr. Greger as he mentions one subset of people who may need to avoid spermidine, and then we'll come back and look at a second group of people.
Alexander says, could a spermidine-rich diet lead to cancer or harm an existing cancer? Oh, that's a cool question. Okay, so spermidine is a DNA-protecting compound. Spermidine actually has the longest lifespan extension. How cool is that? And it's concentrated in healthy foods like tempeh and mushrooms and wheatgerm. And anyway, but anytime you have some cell protective mechanism, you're always concerned about, well, wait a second, what if you have cancer cells? Theoretically, there's this risk. It's like, wait a second, we don't want to protect DNA if we have cancer. I'm not worried about cancer in terms of developing cancer, but what if you already have cancer? If you have active cancer, should you be taking spermidine? I believe the answer is no. I would have to actually look back to How Not to Age, but I have some contraindications. One of the contraindications, I believe, was active cancer. You just don't want to go out of your way to increase spermidine, but I would go to How Not to Age and make sure and not rely on my memory.
In a How Not to Age video linked below, Dr. Greger did say, quote, until we know more, cancer patients perhaps shouldn't go out of their way to increase their spermidine intake, but at the same time may not want to shy away from foods like soy and broccoli that have specifically been associated with improved survival after a cancer diagnosis. He also went on to say that there is another group who he would advise caution for, and those are people with kidney failure. Quote, they have elevated levels of a particular enzyme activity, which means they have higher accumulation of toxic spermidine byproducts, like acrolein, in their bloodstream. And finally, those with dementia, who increase spermidine intake, can experience a drop in vitamin B12 levels in their blood, so their B12 levels need to be monitored. Next, we'll look at some remarkable stories of people beating cancer with the help of a plant-based diet.